So what is a large language model? So I have this very simple example that most of us can relate to. So I started typing this sentence. Let's say I have a large language model that is predicting what might be my next word. So last night I was reading Harry Potter and then now when I look at this, well, these are all of the Harry Potter books. And if I look at these books, the word philosopher, and these are made up probabilities, they don't indicate any real numbers here. And Harry Potter and the philosophers, 4.5%, and sorcerers, 3.2%, and prisoner is 3.1%. So these are all the books, Harry Potter books, and I know what is the next most likely word. Now, what can I do? What I can do here is, I am going to, the way a large language model works is, it takes the, for simplicity's sake, let's actually talk about this, that it goes for the highest probability path. And the next word, of course, it's going to be philosophers, because that's the most likely word that will make the sentence complete. Can it be sorcerers? Of course it can be sorcerers, but you are going for the highest probability word, that is the next word. Now, so what is a large language model? I mean, as fancy as it like. I mean, we talk about deep neural networks. We talk about, you know, these huge neural networks and lots of compute and, you know, NVIDIA releasing GPUs after GPUs and OpenAI, Anthropic, all of them talking about it. Under the hood, they are, well, think of a large language model as a giant statistical model built on a large amount of language data. So in essence, what it is some probabilities. What is the next most probable word? If is basically what data the model was trained on. And that should also, I mean, I'm not going to get into the other challenges like bias and fairness, but your models are going to be a depiction of the data that goes in. If you have data that is biased, if your data has been labeled by people who may have a different understanding. So for instance, right? So if I am in North America right now, and then a model that is trained here on certain things, on certain cultural things or certain social things, right? So there may be a difference and that may result in some discrepancy. And I mean, if you talk about, if the data in bias is going to appear, or the bias in data is going to appear in your model's predictions or models, whatever it generates. So how does it work? Well, in a large language model, it works by you digitize. I mean, whether it's, most of the data, of course, I mean, it's digitized, but you can actually digitize the data if it is not already digitized, put that in your neural network, and then train this model, and that's pretty much it, right? So, and then that's how it works, right? So this is, think of this as a giant, huge neural network. But now, let's actually look at this. I decided to add some context to my example. What is the context? What I'm saying now is, the context that exists is, Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, it was released as Sorcerer's Stone in the US. Scholastic released this book with a different name for whatever marketing reasons. And now what I'm saying here is, last night I was reading Harry Potter and now the next word, I don't know. I'm also adding some context. Remember, I live in New York and I bought my book from the United States, and suddenly, I mean, think about this, that I'm almost tilting the probability. I'm actually shifting the probability in favor of a different next word. I mean, that's really what is happening.